Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today what we're going to talk about are products that I have interest in that look like something I might want to buy eventually. Might not even ever buy these things. I have no clue how it's going to roll out. And I'm not a hyper consumer of products by any stretch of the imagination. I do not buy it like that. I haven't in a while. I really like to use what I have, what I own. I also like to explore new makeup. I like to go on Sephora sometimes and just see what's out, what's new. I like to hear YouTubers talking about different products and seeing how they feel about stuff. I know this is a really weird time. A lot of people are struggling to make ends meet, or they're just being really mindful about how they're purchasing things. I totally understand that. If videos like this, again, I did not buy any of this stuff. This is literally like products in theory that I'm interested in, or just stuff that I thought was cool and maybe one day might get. So if things like that are triggering to you, please do not feel like you need to watch this video. I'm trying to keep things very mindful and respectful of that. On the other hand too, like, I know that there are people who find this really fun in a time like this amidst all this chaos, so it might be a place of calm for some people. So if you're one of those people, then you might really want to watch this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe. I would really appreciate that. Let's just get right into the products. So the first product that I have on my radar are the Fenty Gloss Bombs. Yes, these are everywhere, popular. I don't know if it's just like brand interest. I love that they're inclusive of so many different types of skin tones and they call to me, in particular the colors Sweet Mouth and Fenty Glow. Fenty Glow is the browner one. It's a little bit more nude color, if you will. They're a little bit more accessible of a brand, I think, than say like your really expensive products like Tom Ford, Charlotte Tilbury. And I think I've heard enough good things about them that they're like a quality product. I mean, are they gonna change your life? Probably not. Probably not going to change your life, but I'm sure that they are a really decent product. I can't imagine them being terrible. Let's put it that way. And they look like they're decent. I like the packaging. These are colors that I would wear in everyday life. I would wear them. I would get my use out of them. And therefore, I think that would make the price worth it for me just to try out something in that brand line that I'm already interested in. I'm kind of getting into a gloss phase right now, so it does make sense. And those two colors look totally wearable. You can layer them, I'm sure. Wear them on their own. I think they're very versatile. So that is one product that I'm really interested in trying. The next product is also by Fenty. It is the Fenty Foundation. It's soft matte long wear foundation with buildable coverage, and it is cruelty free. I've heard good things about this foundation. Like, you know, depending on your skin type, it might not be the right fit for some people, but it does appeal to me on some level. That's that brand interest again, and the packaging looks nice. It looks like something that would fit my type of skin. I don't know if it's completely matte. I don't really love like cakey looking matte foundations right now, but it's just the finish looks good. And I think, again, at the price point, it says $35. Not exactly the cheapest, but again, for Sephora prices, it's kind of somewhere in the middle-ish. It's not like super cheap, but it's not that expensive, where to me personally, I know everyone has different budgets, it's a little bit more accessible. So that looks like something I would like to try out. The other thing I'm kind of interested in are CC creams and BB cream. I think with summer approaching, and even just this weird time right now where some days I just don't go out, I might want to try something a little bit more skincare-ish with a little bit of coverage. Higher end ones like your IT Cosmetics, that's probably like $50. And I see that they have mini sizes, but some other ones like that are more affordable would be like ColourPop makes a version of a BB or CC cream. e.l.f. also makes a version. And Jessica Braun on YouTube has mentioned Misha BB cream, or I'm not sure if it's a tinted moisturizer or BB cream, but I just like the idea of having skincare built into lighter foundation. Also, the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea foundation looks really interesting. Now, this might just be like the delivery of the product. It has a dropper in it, so I kind of like, I'm interested in that kind of aspect of it. And it looks kind of like a lighter weight foundation. Again, with the whole like glowy, natural type of look, that might be something I'm interested in because it builds up. Beauty Bakery makes a liquid liner that I'm interested in. Jocelyn Clare has mentioned this as one of her favorite eyeliners, I think. And I am actually in the search for a liquid liner. So that line, Beauty Bakery, is very appealing to me, I think, because I like desserts. that does appeal to me a lot. But besides that fact, I heard it's a really good liquid eyeliner. It's a little bit different than your typical, like, you know, your Stila liquid liner. So that's one I want to build into my rotation eventually. I don't have any Charlotte Tilbury anything in my collection. They do catch my interest, I think, because they're a little bit different than other makeup brands in that, okay, yes, they're a lot more expensive, but I just think that they're made in a way that the effect of the makeup is very subtle but very game-changing, if you know what I'm saying. So for that being said, I've heard a lot of good things about their products. And I really want to check out, though, their Airbrush Flawless Finish Setting Powder. I have so many powders right now, and I know this one probably outperforms all of them, but I'm also in that mindset of, like, let's just finish some stuff, you know? But it does look like it's supposed to make a really big difference in how your makeup sets, maybe how it looks, maybe, like, a glow from within. Their blushes look interesting as well for the same exact reason. They look like they're not, like, in your face, like, super heavy pigmented, but they also bring some sort of like inner light and glow to your face that's maybe a little bit more elevated than other products. I don't know, like, it's hard to say, but will I ever buy them? No clue, but they are pretty, so maybe one day. The other product that has also kind of interested me was the Marc Jacobs bronzer. They make it with white and black packaging. I think the white might be limited edition, but I've heard really good things about this bronzer. I mean, people say it's flattering on them and they, you know, kind of blows other bronzers out of the park. I don't know if that's true. It's expensive though. It's like $49 for, like, I mean, you get a lot of product on it. I've seen it. I don't know if I need that much bronzer in my life, but if I only had to have one bronzer, I would probably like to try that one just because it looks like you get good, your money's worth from it. Maybe it's a lot, it's big. So you would have it for a while at least. It depends. So it is a lot of money, but it's a bronzer, like the only bronzer right now that I'm truly like, ooh, that could be cool. There's also the Hourglass blushes that look really interesting to me. Hourglass and Charlotte Tilbury, they're like sisters to me or something. Like, I know they probably have very different products, but I just feel like they kind of, I guess it's the packaging, it's the prestige behind the both of them. Like, they just kind of seem like alike to me. But their blush looks really interesting, and their ambient lighting powders, like, there's one that comes in a palette, would be interesting to try just because I think that, same with Charlotte Tilbury, like, I think they have like a filtering kind of look to them that is a little bit more advanced. I don't know, I'm not saying it's better than anything else, but I'm curious to try to see what that technology is like and what, you know, how that really would make a difference in your appearance. So, and the packaging again, beautiful. I like packaging. I think it's really pretty, so it looks sturdy too. The classic NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer looks really interesting to me. I only have one concealer right now. Right now I'm using the Wet n Wild. I tend to fluctuate between either drugstore or higher end, and right now obviously I'm doing the drugstore thing, and I like it, nothing against it. I like that it's like inexpensive and it does the job, but I do kind of want to play around with a higher coverage concealer. So I think I've heard good things about that one consistently. I think it's a lot of people's favorites. So, you know, I'm curious about that one. So I want to try it out. I'm sure I would enjoy it. It's something I would use every day. So I wouldn't hesitate to pick one of those up realistically. I feel like some of these products, there's more of a chance of me getting them than others. I'm more likely to pick that up than say a powder that I already have a ton of right now. Do you know what I'm saying? So other things on my list, the Essence Lash Princess. I've heard a lot of hype around this product, and it at the price point, I don't know why I wouldn't want to try it out. It's only $4.99 and I heard it's a great mascara, so I'm really interested to try that one out. That's the next mascara on my list. That's like on a drugstore level. I don't know how I feel about spending a ton on mascara at the moment. Like, I feel like I'm happy with the drugstore ones that I have. I have some mid-range ones as well. Like, I have Tarte one. I have used in the past like samples of higher end. The It Superhero mascara does look really interesting, but I'm concerned about that drying out very quickly because that's kind of what happened to my sample. So even though I enjoyed it, I don't know if it's something that I want to invest in either. So it, you know what I mean? So I'll play it by ear and see if there's any cool like higher end mascaras that I would like to try. But right now, the Essence one would definitely be the next one on my list. The brand Glossier, I also wanna try. I'm interested in the cloud paints. I want an alternative to like powder blushes, you know? And I actually had the Tarte, I don't know, a while ago they made these cheek tints that came in like a bomb. You could like roll it up, it looked like deodorant kind of. And those were so pretty, but they went bad on me. So I ended up getting rid of them. And I still like to have that variety in there of something like tinted, creamy, that you can just, you know, dot on your face. And that looks perfect. They just look really natural, and in particular the shade Dusk looks really nice, because again, I don't really want to do the colored, really bright colors right now. I mean, maybe I will eventually, but right now that one seems to appeal to me. And also from Glossier, I want to try their masks. They have two that come in a set. One that's, I guess, a clay mask for detoxifying. It's called the Mega Greens Galaxy Pack. And I also want to try the Moisturizing Moon Mask for hydration, because back in the day, I used to really be into like anything that sucked out oil and whatever, but I find that over time, maybe it's my age, I don't know. I like more of a moisturized look to my face and healthy, glowy, dewy kind of appearance. So anything that does add moisture back in, I welcome and I enjoy, and I feel like it just feels so much more soothing. And I really like that this brand offers both, and that you could get both if you wanted. Cause like, I think there's a time and a place for a clay mask, you know, definitely, especially with summer coming up and all that. But I also want to try a moisturizing mask as well, because I think that would feel really, really good as well. Because I think moisture in general, whether you have oily skin, dry skin, whatever, like it can't hurt, you know? So I'm really interested in those two. I'm kind of going to combine these three together because I'm not looking to buy eyeshadow at all. But if I were to, these would be the ones that I would be most interested in. The Makeup Geek 9 pan eyeshadows that you can customize do appeal to me. Like, I know she did a rebranding recently. I mean, I heard the formula before was great, but I think she even upgraded that. I love the idea of getting to pick out your own eyeshadows and put them in a pan. That's nothing new. Quality's supposed to be really good for the price. It's like a 9 pan that you could fill up for like $38, which I don't think is a terrible price. It's not like drugstore prices, but I think sometimes you get what you pay for depending on the brand. For me, that seems reasonable considering you can get like a bunch of shadows that you won't even use for like way more, you know what I mean? And I love the fact that Makeup Geek doesn't like shove products down your throat. She likes the idea of people using up their makeup, hitting pan on things, and you know, that is important. And I feel like Marlena, like the owner of the brand, like she's kind of like an OG makeup artist that's kind of been around for a long time. She's had her ups and downs with like, you know, working with other brands and stuff, not to get into specifics. To me, she seems like a brand that I would feel comfortable supporting. Wouldn't hesitate to pick one of those up again if I was looking to buy eyeshadow. Other eyeshadows, listen, I'm a MAC girl. That's one of the first brands that I ever really started buying makeup from, like when I was getting more into makeup. So two shades, really basic, would be just be like Saddle and Brown Script. I think they're just brown eyeshadows. So I've been kind of into like old school favorites, and I'm a MAC girl. I'm a MAC girl, and I find that I've been looking through like old MAC favorites, like watching videos of people's like standards. And again, I'm not here to buy more eyeshadow at all. And in fact, I could probably dupe these colors in my kit somewhere. But the color Saddle and Brown Script, they're just brown eyeshadows, but I think they would be workhorse eyeshadows. Like when you want that kind of vibe, they'd be easy to put in the crease, easy to make a look out of. So again, they're not like, they don't look that special if you just look at the eyeshadow in the pan, but I just, there's something about just like classic shades that work. And those two would be colors that I would be happy to bring into my collection if I was buying eyeshadow. I don't need to say it again, but I'm not looking to buy eyeshadow, but those two colors are kind of cool. So I would do that. Again, are they dupable? Sure. Am I gonna buy them? Probably not, but pique my interest a little bit. Now these are, you know, Hourglass and Charlotte Tilbury again, and I kind of get these confused a little bit. One is the Hourglass Scattered Lights eyeshadow, and the other is the Charlotte Tilbury Eyes to Mesmerize cream eyeshadow. Both are kind of pricey. Like one eyeshadow, I think from Hourglass, the cream is like $29, and the one from Charlotte Tilbury is $32. Probably never gonna buy these in my lifetime, but again, you never know, but they look beautiful. I've heard good things about them. And again, you know, back to that brand kind of interest, there's something about them that's special that isn't just like pigmentation, right? Because I feel like, you know, a lot of times that's kind of how people judge makeup, is by pigmentation, when there are, and I'm not against a good pigment. Like I get it. Trust me. Like I like when my eyeshadows give off the payoff that I want, or I can build it up or whatever. But I'm interested in other types of aspects of makeup that make it quality besides that. And those two eyeshadows, I've heard really good things about those two, and they just make your eyes, they bring out your eyes in a way that like maybe other eyeshadows don't. Again, I don't know if that's true. I don't see myself spending the money right now to find out, but one day, you know, maybe I would like to like swatch it in Sephora. Maybe one day I might splurge on it. I don't really know. But those are just two more eyeshadows that were interesting to me that were a little higher end. Things like this don't trigger me to buy stuff. It kind of just heightens my awareness a little bit about what I'm into. And it's fun. I think it's part of the fun of makeup. It's not just, you know, hoarding it or just using it or decluttering it or throwing it out or, you know, project pans, which I love all that stuff. But a little part of me loves to just browse and see what's out there and maybe pick something up eventually.
nothing is an emergency, nothing is urgent. And I like to keep the mindfulness within my makeup spending. So it's always nice to have a little list going of things you could potentially want. I might wait for a sale, I might not wait for a sale. We'll see how life goes, but those are it. If you have any interest in any of those, I wanna hear from you or from any product or brand that interests you, definitely leave a comment below and don't forget to like and subscribe if you found any of this likable or subscribable. Have a great day, guys. I will see you in my next video. Bye.